George Allen changes quarterbacks and his Washington Redskins lead by 3 at the half. And so, Irv Cross, what do you think of Billy Kilmer so far? He's about your age.
Well, he's a year or two older than I am. But you remember, the first offensive drive the Redskins had, he took him the length of the field and threw a touchdown pass to Calvin Hill. Then in the closing minute or so of the first half, controlled the clock very well to get a field goal. So experience is coming through.
Speaking of control today, the Cincinnati Bengals seized control of the race in the AFC Central as they defeated the Pittsburgh Steelers 17-10. It was a tough weekend for Chuck Knoll. He slipped on the ice, broke his arm the night before the ball game. His team started off this way. Bradshaw back to throw his first pass. Lamar Parrish swoops in, intercepts, and runs 48 yards for the touchdown, and Cincinnati moved ahead by 7 points. 5 turnovers by the Steelers. This next possession, fumble by Blyer, recovered by Bacon. And it was Pat McAnally replacing the injured Isaac Curtis, who caught this pass by Kenny Anderson and got the Bengals to the 1 yard line. Cincinnati gambled on 4th and goal. They went to Pete Johnson, and the Steelers held him right there and took over. Back they came, Bradshaw carefully driving the Steelers. What kind of a field condition was it? Look at the ice that Cunningham is knocked down on after a 26-yard gain. As they start the second quarter, Franco Harris broke across, and the Steelers had tied it. Then it was Bradshaw. Where did that man come from? Who is that guy?
Bradshaw,
back to pass, looking for Lynn Swann, a very costly reception. Swann has got it, but he sustains a hip pointer, and he is out for the rest of the game. That set up a Pittsburgh field goal. The Steelers move ahead by 3. Back comes Anderson, driving the Bengals, looking for Brooks this time. This is a 57-yard pass play, set up a 25-yard bar field goal, tied at 10. The cruel afternoon wore on. Jim LeClair out, frostbite. Then it was the Steelers who seized control, but then they fumbled the kickoff, and Cincinnati had a chance. Anderson going to McAnally down the sideline, 43 yards, and Cincinnati beats Pittsburgh 17-10. Bradshaw's last chance as time ran out. He overthrew Stallworth by about a yard, and you can see that Cincinnati and Pittsburgh are tied right now at 8-5, but because Cincinnati won by 7 points today, if they beat Houston next Sunday, they would beat the Steelers by a single point in the tie-breaking method. Of course, that is saying that Pittsburgh will also beat San Diego. It is going to be that close in the AFC Central. Speaking of a race that was close, how about the one out in the AFC West, Denver and Oakland, and a special tribute to those Denver Broncos.
Denver has surprised everyone this year. We have a nice music piece today with one of my favorite singers singing a terrific song that we all love. John Denver might have had Craig Morton in mind when he wrote this beautiful song about Colorado experience, Rocky Mountain High. After disappointing seasons in Dallas and New York, the Denver quarterback seems kind of revitalized with the Broncos. And after 12 games this season, his team has the best record in pro football. And he also has taken a lovely new bride named Susan. Craig Morton truly seems to be experiencing a Rocky Mountain High.
He was born in the summer of his 27th year, coming home to a place he'd never been before. He left yesterday behind him. You might say he was born again. You might say he found the key for every door. When he first came to the mountains, his life was far away. But the string's already broken, and he doesn't really care. It keeps changing fast, and it don't last for long. And the Colorado Rocky Mountain High, I've seen it rain and fire in the sky. Talk to God and listen to the casual. Rocky Mountain High. Serenity of a Rocky Mountain High.
It's indeed a Rocky Mountain High for Craig Morton, a new wife, a winning team, and Super Bowl possibilities. Isn't that great?
Cinderella walks amongst the mountaintops in Colorado. And the NFL Today will continue on CBS after these messages from your local stations.
Kojak is moving to Saturdays. Watch Telly Savalas as Kojak tonight at 10, 9 Central and Mountain on CBS.
George Allen rightly figured that he was going to have to score more points on this Saturday afternoon than he has recently. Mike Thomas taking a handoff from his new quarterback, Billy Kilmer, and he bolts down to the Cardinal 42. Then it was Clarence Harmon with a crushing block by Thomas on Arneson, and Harmon got to the 18-yard line. Billy Kilmer, 5 touchdown passes this year, 4 of them against the Cardinals. Here's Calvin Hill breaking across. It was 7-0 Washington. And it looked like it was going to be a rout for the grand old men when Scott stepped up, intercepted this pass by Hart, and got all the way to the St. Louis 25-yard line. But St. Louis's defense held. Mosley kicked a field goal. It was 10-0, and the Cardinals got their act together. Bakken then got them on the scoreboard with this field goal, and it was 10-3. Kilmer trying to rally the Redskins again, and here was a big turnover. Hits Calvin Hill on that same pattern they ran for the touchdown, but this time Hill fumbles and Giblin recovers for St. Louis. St. Louis then went on a march. 2 big plays. This is number 1, draw play with Terry Metcalf. He gets down to the 25-yard line, but the Washington defense held. It was 2nd and 20, and it was Hart looking for Ike Harris, and he got him. And Harris got the first down as he got to the 5-yard line. Now watch 3rd and goal from the 1-foot line. Steve Jones and the officials say he crossed the plane. It was tied at 10. Then Billy Kilmer brought Washington back down, and Mosley kicked this 23-yarder. So we stand 13-10 at the half. And Irv Cross, when you were out in St. Louis this week, I understand that they say that losing record doesn't really belong to the Chicago Cardinals. What's that all about?
This is what it's all about. Managing general partner Bill Bedwell said that record in the record book of 29 consecutive losses of the Chicago Cardinals should not be there. What it should be is simply this. The losing streak in Chicago was 19 straight games, and then the team was combined into the Shy Pitt team. At that point, they lost 10 consecutive games. So Bidwell is saying that there ought to be an asterisk in the record book making it 19 consecutive losses for Chicago Cardinals, not 29. And if that's true, the record then is held today by the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
To Irv Cross, and he'll answer everything right to the point.
Boy, did you just make John McKay's Saturday afternoon. The NFL Today will continue on CBS in just a moment.
and started to slide off of it.
Allen gets away from one tackler, gets away from another, and goes out of bounds. Deeper in Cardinal territory. Roger Worley, I believe, finally got him out of bounds. He slipped away from Eric Williams and Steve Neals.
Patrick,
checkoff.
Patrick, they put Gene Fugit there as a tight end on that side. They get Kenny Reeves in man-to-man. And the outside linebacker on that side is never looking through at number 35. And he's sitting right there telling you. He might have delayed just a count or so before he came.
George Allen giving the signals.
His hand may freeze today.
Yeah. Here's Mike Thomas. Mike Thomas down to about the 25. There's a flag down on the play. Kearney Bradley on the tackle.
Looked like the Cardinals tried to fire that left side linebacker. Oh. Offensive holding. It's just about the perfect play if you can cut off the linebacker, but you can't hold to do it, can you?
Walk off against Washington. That'll make it first and 20.
Holding. Offense. Number 74. First down.
That's George Stark. Don Coryell with a concerned look, to say the least. 16-13 the score, Redskins over the Cardinals. Caught by Bugs. Quick slant in, stopped by Carl Allen. But Steve, they got some of it back.
And Steve Neal, the outside linebacker, never looked back at the quarterback at all. Kilmer just slipped it right on by.
That's the end of the third quarter with the score. Washington 16, St. Louis 13. We now pause for a word from your local station.